Hello friends, so as you can see, today I am going to teach you the basics of the radix sort algorithm. So as you can see from the video, the radix sort is a linear sorting algorithm. It uses the concept of sorting in alphabetical order. It uses the concept of buckets, hence it is also known as bucket sort. The example which begins next will help you understand better the working of the bucket sort or the radix sort algorithm. So here is the example. The following numbers will be taken and they will be sorted in alphabetical order, or rather in ascending order, using the bucket sort algorithm. So this is the format of the bucket table. As you can see on the left, we have numbers from 0 to 9, which each represent 10 buckets. That is, the numbers will be inserted in each of the buckets according to the digits at the units place, then at the tens place, and at the hundreds place. Or in technical terms, if we see from the least significant digit to the most significant digit. So this is the format of the bucket sort table, as you can see. Now there are a few important points to be remembered before we start the actual sorting process. As I've said before, sorting is done on each of the digits in the number. The sorting starts from the least significant digit and goes to the most significant digit in the number. The number of passes is decided by the number of digits in the largest number. For example, if the largest number has 4 digits, then there will be 4 passes taken for the sorting of the numbers. So here it is. Now we begin the pass 1. So as I've said before, the sorting will start from the units place or the least significant number and will go up to the most significant number. So now as we start sorting, we'll first insert the number 315 into the appropriate bucket. So as you can see, the number 315 contains 5 at the units place or at the least significant digit. So it will be inserted in the appropriate bucket, that is the bucket of number 5. So as you can see, it is inserted at bucket 5 and at position 1. Similar process will be carried out for all the numbers until the entire array is inserted in its proper place in the buckets. So as you can see, 221 will also be inserted in its proper place. So it is inserted into the bucket 1 and position 1. Next, 123 at bucket 3, 886 at bucket 6, 796, as you can see at the first position at bucket 6, there is already the number 886. So 796 will be inserted in the second place at the bucket 6. 286, the similar condition occurs, so it will be inserted at the third place. Then 889 at the ninth bucket. And finally 105 at the fifth bucket and second position. So as you can see, all the numbers have been placed in the perfect buckets. Now we simply have to collect these numbers in a single array. So now the array becomes 221, 123, 315, 105, 886, 796, 286 and 289. The numbers simply have to be collected in the order in which they occur in the buckets. So now we begin the pass 2 of the algorithm. So as you can see, now we will sort the number according to the digits at the tens place. So we start again. 221 will be placed in the second bucket, since at the tens place there is a number 2. Similarly, in a similar fashion, the other numbers will also be placed in their respective buckets. So 123 at the second place and second bucket, 315 in bucket 1, 105 at the zeroth bucket, since there is the number or digit 0 at the tens place of the number 105, 886 at the 8th bucket, 796 9th bucket, 286 at the 8th bucket 2nd position, and finally 889 at the 8th bucket 3rd position. So we again do the same task of collecting the numbers into a single array in the order in which they occur. So here is the array after the second pass. You can read it once. And now we move to the pass 3 of this algorithm. So here it is, pass 3. Now we consider the number at the hundreds place, or in technical terms, if we say the number at the most significant place, most significant digit. So here it is, we start again. 105 at the first bucket, since there is a number 1 at the hundreds place or the most significant digit. Then 315 at bucket 3, then 221 at bucket 2, 123 at bucket 1 and 2nd position, 886 at bucket 8, 286 at bucket 2 and 2nd position, 889 bucket 8, and second position 796 at bucket 7. Now we again collect the numbers in the order in which they occur. So here it is, we have collected the numbers, and as you can see from the video, the array is totally sorted in the ascending order. Now there are a few important points to be remembered. The bucket table should contain the digits from 0 to 9 for the buckets, and the capacity of each bucket should be taken according to the number of items to be sorted. As you have seen in the example, the capacity of each bucket in an example is to store 10 numbers or 10 items inside the array. However, if the array is quite large, this can be extended to 20, 25 or even 1000 items per bucket. So it all depends on the number of items to be processed and sorted inside the array. The number of passes in the radix sort will always be equal to the number of the digits in the largest number. The largest number contains 5 digits, then the passes will be 5. The largest number contains 10 digits, then the passes will be 10 for the algorithm. So this is the conclusion. Radix sort is basically one of the fastest sorting algorithm and programmed properly and on an array of equal length of numbers. As in our example, all the numbers have only 3 digits, so it becomes quite fast to sort the algorithm. However, the radix sort can become a disadvantage if the numbers are not of equal length. It becomes relatively slow. Consider an example where half of the numbers inside the array contain 3 digits and half of the numbers contain 5 and 6 digits. So due to this unequal length, the sorting process can become relatively slow using the radix sort algorithm. Thank you. Please do like, share and subscribe if you have enjoyed watching the video.